that, you know, firstly, I want to say at the NERA event, I spoke at that NERA event, and I didn't say Mr. Morgan Tsvangirai should lead the coalition per se. I said we are working with him.
Yeah, you spoke about the BVRA.
Yes, I spoke about the BVRA. Well, thank you for that. So that's number one. Then secondly, yes, I have said before that, you know, the MDCT and Mr. Morgan Tsvangirai cannot be ignored in coalition talks in Zimbabwe. You know, that is true. I've said that. You know, I've said that. You see, and where all this is coming from is just the fact that, you know, Zimbabweans, you know, the best way forward at the present moment is to make sure that we build a formidable alliance to remove Mugabe. And that alliance needs everybody who can make a meaningful contribution to it. It doesn't need, of course, everybody per se who is in the opposition, because some of these opposition political parties, Zanu-PF, is forming. So we need all the serious players that we can bring on board to build an alliance to defeat Mugabe. But, and that, to me, I was saying, that can't exclude the MDC, given that is one of the main opposition political parties in this country. The work they've done and their role in opposition politics in this country can't be ignored or overlooked. And that's why we said we need to make sure that any coalition talks needs to make sure the MDCT is part of it. And so we still stand by that assertion. But of course, what is our view about a coalition? A coalition is a necessity. We feel that as a nation now, we need to put our differences aside and concentrate on working together and build a formidable alliance to remove Mugabe. But having said that, I don't want to overlook the fact that we need to take due diligence to make sure that we build an alliance that is not infiltrated, that is solid, that can run, that can last all the way to 2018. Because it's also easy, if you overlook all these factors, it's very easy to build an alliance that can probably break in 4 or 5 months, way before the election. And then what do? You go back to the drawing board. You are in a worse off position before the election. So we have said, let's take due diligence. Let's consider, let's do a background check on all the possible players that are coming into that alliance. And then let's know who they are, what they represent, whether they represent what the Zimbabwean people expect of them. Then let's build a solid coalition. As for who should be leader of that coalition, absolutely, that is for the people of Zimbabwe to decide. Like I've said, you know, the people of Zimbabwe have got a right to decide who they want to lead them when it comes to that coalition. And also the political players that will be part of that coalition will have to decide who becomes leader of the coalition. And I think it's one of the processes that we are looking into, in fact, to make sure that we come up with one candidate. And that candidate will make sure that he or she is a very solid candidate, you know, who should be able to run for president and win the election and deliver the nation out of the problems and challenges we have. So that is coming, and that is one of the things we're discussing as various players. And I'll tell you, when we make the announcement, you'll be very happy and pleased with that announcement.
Now the story, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page, 263chat.